CIET-NCERT presents curriculum-based series Dhwani Shala. So, let's join in Dhwani Shala, Class 3.
Hello, my dear little kids. How are you all? I hope you all must be having lots of fun and learning too. I am Pooja Rana, your maths companion, and I am back with one more mathemagical session. I was missing you a lot. Were you also missing me? I think yes. So here I am with one more fun-filled math session. Before we move ahead, let us reflect the last session. In the last session, we did Chapter 2, Fun with Numbers from Math Magic Grade 3 textbook. We did a lot of fun with numbers up to 1000. We did an interesting story wherein we solved many problems as well. We compared the numbers and estimated the quantity as well. Hey, I do remember that I gave some home activity too. Now tell me, how many of you did those activity with your elders? It was a guessing game. So I hope you all must have had a great experience. Dear children, today is the second episode of Chapter 2. In this session, we are going to learn more numbers and do fun with them, because this unit's name is Fun with Numbers. So let us begin today's session. So, in today's session, we will start with an interesting cricket match. How many of you love to watch cricket match? I just love to watch cricket match. Now, listen to me carefully. This match is about Dhoni's century. Hey, how many of you have heard about Dhoni? Yes, Mahinder Singh Dhoni, who is the former captain of our Indian cricket team. One day match between India and South Africa in Guwahati is going on. India is batting first. Now, one commentator is saying, Dhoni on 96, only one ball left. Will he complete the century? And look at this, what a marvelous six. Now, the other anchor of the program asks, has he completed his century? Now, children, tell me if Dhoni has completed his century or not. What does century means? Okay, tell me first how many balls were left. Yes, only one ball was left. Okay, now tell me how much had Dhoni scored at that point? Yes, absolutely right. He was on 96. Now, tell me, how many runs did Dhoni hit on the last ball? Yes, it was a 6. So, how much Dhoni scored? Let us calculate. He was on 96 and he hit a 6. So, 96 plus 6 is equal to 102 runs. Now, has he completed century? Yes, because century means 100 runs. Like we say dozen for 12 things, we use decade for number 10. Just like that, we use century for 100. Okay, children. Now, let us play a game. I will tell you some players run who are near to complete their century. You will have to tell me that how many runs do these players need to complete a century. So, are you ready? Okay. Player 1 scored 93 runs. How many runs are needed to complete the century? Think and tell me. Yes, you are right. 7 more runs are needed. Now, children, tell me, how did you think? How did you solve it? Give your response to your parents. Okay, player 2 scored 97 runs. So now tell me, how many runs are needed to complete the century? Think? Yes, 3 more runs. This time you did it faster. How? Think, how did you solve it this time? I just counted on from 97 to reach the number 100 and got my answer. Hey, did you do the same way? Okay. Player 3 scored 89 runs. Now tell how many more runs are needed to complete the century. Think. Hey, this time you are taking time. Yes, the answer is 11. Now again, just revisit your thoughts and try to describe how did you solve it. Player 4 scored 99 runs. How many more runs are required to complete the century? Yes, absolutely right. Only 1 run is needed. Now tell me, children, if player 1 who scored 99 runs and scored 6 on the next ball, then what will be his score? 99 runs and 6 more runs. Yes, 105 runs. So, children, we have come beyond 100 and counting goes on like this. Okay, tell me, what comes after 99? Yes, 100. And still the counting goes on like 101, 102, 103, 104, and so on and on and on. Now, children, you will have to count more and more numbers up to 199. And do you know what will come just after 199? Yes, 200. And again, after 200, the counting will go on like 201, 202, 203, 204, and so on. Hey children, can you write the numbers given by me in your notebooks in the words? Okay, take out your notebooks and we will do some fun. So, shall we begin? Okay. Number 99. What will be the spelling? Yes. N-I-N-E-T-Y 90. N-I-N-E-9. Good. Now, 100. 100. How will you call it? Yes, 100. And The spelling is O-N-E-1-H-U-N-D-R-E-D, hundred. Okay, the next number is 111. How will you call it? Yes, 111. And what will be its spelling? O-N-E-1-H-U-N-D-R-E-D, hundred, E-L-E-V-E-N, 11. Okay, children. Now I will tell you the number name and you will have to write its numeral form. That means in numbers. Okay, so are you ready? 89. How will you write it? Yes, 8 and 9. 89. Okay, 101. Well done, kids. You all are doing great. Oh, 200 is a big number. And after it, again, counting will go like 201, 202, 203. Oh, 206. Okay, guess how many more are needed to make a triple century? Think. Yes, absolutely correct. 94. How we did it? First, we think of a triple century means, which means 300. And then we subtracted 206 from 300. Okay, great. Now it is some practice time. Hey kids, now I am going to tell you top 10 scores in the Cricket World Cup. If you have book with you, then you can open page number 17. And if you don't have book, no worries at all. You may note down these scores in your notebook. So children, take out your books or notebooks quickly. Now, I will tell you the top 10 scores. APJ, player scored 128 runs. AS player scored 100 runs. CK scored 99. DM scored 162. KSP scored 152 runs. MD scored 178 runs. PK scored 105 runs. ST scored 141 runs. TPK scored 112 runs. And last, VVS scored 127 runs. I hope you must have noted down all the scores. Now it's question time. CK just missed his century. How many runs did he need to make a century? So first we will look at the CK score. He scored 99 and he is just one run behind the century. So CK needs only one run to make a century. Okay, who scored almost equal runs? AS scored 100 runs and CK scored 99 runs, which is almost equal. Now tell me, who scored a century? Correct. AS scored exact 100 runs, which is a century. Okay. Who scored the highest runs? Absolutely right. MD scored the highest runs. That is 178 runs. Great going, children. Which players have a difference of just one run between them? Which players have a difference of just one run between them? Oh, great! This time you gave answer so quickly. It is the same answer of previously asked question. AS and CK? APJ and VVS. They both are having the difference of just one run between them. Now, last question. Who scored two more than one and a half century? This is a tricky one. For this, we have to find out one and a half century means. So, century means 100. And half century means half of 100. That is 50 runs. So 100 plus 50 equal to 150 runs. Now add two more runs to 150. Yes, 152. So who scored 152 runs? Yes, it is KSP. Well done, children. Hey, kids. This is now time for my favorite section, story time. Dear children, I know you love to listening stories. And even I love to listening stories a lot. So let me tell you a story. This story is very much known to you. Its name is Rabbit and Tortoise. But this time it has a twist. So let us see what the twist is. Once upon a time, there were two friends lived in a forest. Bunny the rabbit and Tony the tortoise. They were best friends. One day, Bunny the rabbit challenged Tony the tortoise that he cannot defeat him in the race. Because Bunny knew that Tony cannot run faster than him. So the tortoise accepted the challenge. He said he could run faster than him. So the race began. Bunny the rabbit was very confident of his fast racing skills. So he was not worried at all. But Tony the tortoise had a trick this time. He had placed milestones in the racing track. And they were placed like 10, 20, 30 and so on up to 100. Now Tony the tortoise started jumping on the stones. And he was about to reach at the finish line. Bunny the rabbit was just amazed to see the Tony and asked, "Wow, how did you do that?" Tony told Bunny about the jumping on the 10th milestone. He said, "It was so easy. I just skip in 10s and reach the finish line." Bunny the rabbit also hopped onto the 10s and reached 100 finish line. This is how both the friends finished the race and enjoyed skipping in tens. So children, can you do counting in tens? Okay, let me give you some counting and we will skip in tens. Okay, 10, 20, 30. Now how will the counting goes on? Yes, it will goes on like 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and 100. Okay. If I start from 110, then how will counting goes on? Yes, 120, 130, 140, 150, 160, 170, 180, 190, and 200. Great! So in this way, we can count up to 1000. Okay. Now, when Bunny and Tony were enjoying skipping in tens. Meanwhile, Jiffy, the monkey, showed them how to climb counting in 50s. Can you all guess how this Mr. Jiffy monkey climbing the rope counting in 50s? Yes? Yes. He will climb like 50, 100, 150, 200, 250. And what will come after 250? If he is skipping 50 numbers? Yes, 300. Again 50 more. 350. Again 50 more. 400. 450. 500. How far can you go like this? Yes, we can go limitless. Okay, what is the biggest number you can call out? Tell me. Think over it. Okay, children, it is now some fun time. Let us all play a game. For this game to play, we need a paper, a pencil, and green, red, and yellow crayons. So let us get set ready with the material. Meanwhile, those kids who are having math magic book with them, they can play this game in the book on page number 19. Those kids who do not have book, they can make a table of 30 boxes. Make a big box which have 30 boxes in it. For this, you will have to draw 5 columns and 6 rows. Okay, now I am just telling you the numbers and you can write them in the table. I am telling you the first row numbers. 7, 4, 4. 5, 5, 5. 6, 5, 6. 1, 9, 5. 4, 5, 4. 8, 0, 0. Now the numbers in next row. 8, 1, 0. 3, 7, 4. 1, 4, 0. 1, 5, 5. 1, 3, 6. 4, 4, 5. 4, 5. 1, 7, 1. 1, 7, 9. 4, 1, 0. 6, 0. 6, 4, 2. Next row. 4, 0, 1. 2, 6, 1. 8, 9, 1, 1, 5, 9, 7, 4, 2, 0, 2. Last row. 5, 4, 1, 5, 9, 1, 6, 6, 8, 5, 6, 9, 9, 4, 3. Now find the numbers in this table and color them as I say. color the boxes which have numbers green 140, 202, 261, okay, 300 plus 70 plus 4. Okay, now color the boxes red which have numbers 555, 810. Okay, now take yellow color. Color the box yellow which has number 16. Now 74. Okay, now 1 plus 90 plus 80. Good. Okay, children, this was it for today. Today, we learnt numbers beyond 100 and idea of century. We also did some fun games with numbers up to 1000. We learnt skip counting in 10s and 50s. Home activity. Now it's time for some home activity. We all will write skip counting in 10s up to 200, skip counting in 50s up to 1000, and skip counting in 20s up to 500. So children, this was all for today. I hope you liked the session and fun games. Keep learning, keep exploring. Thank you.
Friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistant, Kusum Lata. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and Mayank Kumar. Produced by Vimlesh Chaudhary. And this program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.